Hey, what's up out there in football land? It's Sonya Anderson, your host of another edition of All Things Football. This is going to be a brief one, y'all. I just wanted to check in and give you guys some more news. Today, the NFL handed down one of the greatest penalties ever against former Panthers owner Jerry Richardson, ordered to pay over $2 million in fines for his misconduct while he was owner of the Panthers. And in Panther news, additionally, Mr. Tepperz will not be giving out sub-ownership. He will be the primary owner. He does not wish to do anything more. The $75 million he has sublet out for another time, but he's already paid over $2 billion for the Carolina Panthers, which makes them one of the top-selling teams in NFL history. T.I. comes out and states that he is going to be boycotting the NFL and the Super Bowl. And as you all know, the Super Bowl will be held in Atlanta next year, next February 2019. So this is going to be huge because a lot of Atlanta talent is here. And I thought personally that it would be a hip-hop slash rap slash trap music Super Bowl. But apparently, T.I. has already put out there that he will not be supporting the NFL because of the stance the NFL has taken continuously, as I talked about on all of my other shows, the kneeling during the national anthem. Now, you will remember that players must stay in the locker room during the national anthem or else not be allowed to demonstrate. Those taking a knee will be fined as well as penalized 15 yards from the kickoff at the beginning of the game. All right. Jameis Winston, breaking news, was facing a 6-game suspension, has gotten 3-game suspension as of today. The NFL is going through and through suspending these players 4, 6, 3 games for PED violations. This is probably one of the heaviest years that I've seen players suspended, and that's going to be costly for the Tampa Bay organization because you know they were struggling for the last 2 seasons, and apparently Jameis is their key player. So it will be interesting to see who they choose to go ahead and go in his stand. His backup quarterback is going to definitely have to get out there and start throwing and getting familiar with the plays because obviously he's going to have to be ready to go come August slash September. It's a lot of stuff going on. New York Giants quarterback Mr. Janaris, his brother is charged with homicide after a body was found in the New York Giants quarterback home. Now he's in Florida and he's been advised to stay there, and accordingly his brother has now been arrested and charged with this murder. So I'll be following up on that story. There's a lot of breaking news. It's always ongoing. OTAs are still in the midst. Things that are going on within the organizations. The Patriots are still shaking things up. The Eagles, everybody, everywhere. Dez Bryant is still unsigned. So we are interested to see what's going to happen with that. The rookies are coming out, throwing strong, throwing long, and so it's a productive season. I'm excited. It's the end of June. That means we only have about 6 more weeks before the season's going to kick off, including the preseason. So stay tuned. Please share this channel. Subscribe. Follow us on Facebook, All Things Football from a Lady's Perspective. On Instagram, you can follow me, Mrs. S. Anderson 2011, and you can also follow me on Facebook. It's S-O-N-J-A, last name Anderson. Feel free to drop your comments and email us if you'd like, carolinapantherettes@gmail.com. I'm the founder of that great all ladies organization, so just Google us. Have a great day, and again, thank you for tuning in.